Hi guys, how are you going? It's Campbell here from Autodidactic Channel. And as always, autodidactic means to be self-educated, guys, and you want to be self-educated because you don't want to be learning what they are trying to teach us. Today I want to talk about trams and the electric tram systems that were in all the cities. As far as I can see, they were all through Australia, America, Europe. They were just everywhere, and they were all electric. And this is back at the turn of the century, up until the 1940s and 50s, really, when they were ripped out pretty much. And so what happened is, this was all done by the greedy people, the men who want to be gods on earth. And these people are the same people that are in power today. And what As far as I can work out, they want to be gods on earth. That their plan is to own the earth, own all the resources, and own all the people, and charge us for living here. And that way they get everything, and they can literally become, material gods on earth. And this all started back, well, a long time ago, but in the modern era, if we're talking post-mud flood, which we really don't know what went on before the mud flood because they changed history. But after the mud flood, it starts with one of the lines is the Rockefeller line, who J.D. Rockefeller started Standard Oil, and they basically took over so many different industries and destroyed them, and especially things like electric trams, which were their opposition, their competition. And so, that's what I want to talk about today. So hang around and we shall get into it. Okay, guys, let's get into this. So, you can see there was trams around, electric trams at the turn of the century, lots of them. And where are they now is the question. What happened to them? Because trams, when they were running, they were free as well. People weren't charged to ride them. They'd just run their course, and people would just hop on them and then hop off when they wanted to. And they kind of moved so slowly that they didn't really need to stop. People would just sort of hop on and hop off them, free to ride, clean energy as long as you're getting the electricity from a clean source, and obviously these have now gone, and we've been replaced with gas and diesel buses and cars. We now have smog and pollution and traffic congestion and road rage and everything else that goes along with it. I mean, obviously, the cities are bigger now, there's more people in them. But yeah, this is what happened. You can see back here, I mean, there's cars in the streets, but there's just trams going up and down. People are just jumping on and off them. Look at all this architecture, by the way. This is Adelaide, circa 1900. And so what happened is, after the flood, opportunists, now how they, whether they knew the flood, the mud flood or the cataclysms were coming, whether they had prior knowledge or they even instigated them, we don't know. But for whatever reason, they sort of came out, and were in the position where they could just take advantage. And they did. There's a lot of evidence that they went around and basically killed a lot of the adults that were left. Not long after, we have things like the 1812 war in America. There's also the Napoleonic Wars, all these wars everywhere, and to wipe out the adults that were left and to kill the history, basically. And that way they could rewrite history in whatever vein they wanted to. And that's what they have gone ahead and done, and that's quite provable. We know history's been rewritten, and history has even had 1,000 years taken out of it. I've got a video on that if you haven't seen it yet. It's worth a watch. And so what they did is, when you get free energy, and of course there's a lot of videos on Tartarian architecture, and our free energies, through the spires and the antennas and the domes and fireplaces and all this kind of stuff. Seems that it was probably based on steam, that the buildings were releasing steam, and that was reacting with water vapors, which creates electrical currents, and the currents and the electricity was being captured by the antenna, and yeah, the domes were somehow how they got it down to wherever they were using it or storing it. So we still don't know how that worked. But if you do look around, there's also videos. If you check out churches in your area, a lot of them are grounded from their spires down to the ground. They're grounded, so they don't work anymore. So it was all free. And now, when things are free, obviously you can't control people. And there were people around who wanted to control the population. They weren't happy with just everyone being happy for some reason. So this is the other big question: is who are these people? What are these people? Are they human? Are they us? Because they seem to really, really have a dislike for humans. Obviously, they're trying to wipe us out. They're destroying our food, our environment, our ethics. Our health, our what's the word? Our drive, our ability to dream and to go forward. People are getting more pessimistic and more hopeless all the time because they don't believe that they can get out and change and actually live the life they want. And this is the biggest thing that they've done. And that's also why they took away history, because if everyone knew exactly what went on and who we were descended from, and what our predecessors had achieved, then we wouldn't be feeling like this. We would know how amazing we all are, and we are, guys. So yeah, what happened is Rockefeller and his cohorts, they found oil and realized that with oil you could put it in barrels and pumps and you could sell it to people, because oil burns. You need to keep renewing it, and petroleum products and all this kind of stuff. So if you can get the supply of that and control the supply, you can then sell it to people. And it's always done under the guise of, they're trying to, they're solving our problems. It's problem reaction solution kind of thing. And they still use that today, but obviously it is starting to get a lot of holes in it. So this is what's happened, is they've basically come along with oil, and with that they don't like the free electricity trams. So they have, when I say they, it's the Rockefellers, J.D. Rockefeller, Standard Oil and his cohorts. And yeah, they have ripped out all the tracks, destroyed all the car, all the tram, excuse me, all the trams, so they can have control. So they can have control. Now, with a lot of these tram tracks as well, is what I want to say is, it's with all the stuff I've seen, it's my opinion that these were already here and they were uncovered. That's why when you look at pictures, some of them are deep, some of them have been dug out, and some of them are on the surface, like in Fremantle here, where there might have only been a small, slight covering of mud or whatever. This picture probably is a bit better because you can see they've ripped up the road here. It looks like it was paved maybe, and they've got this in, but all the boards and that, like, it's fully, it doesn't look like they've put gravel in between. It looks like they've literally, it looks like that in between the sleepers looks like mud. Okay, the same as out here. I mean, I know it's not the best quality photo, guys, but it doesn't look like gravel's been poured in. It looks like they've sort of uncovered these tracks and scraped this back, rather than having it at a lower level, putting the sleepers down on top and then laying the tracks. It looks like it's been uncovered. That's just what it looks like to me anyway. So this, as far as I'm concerned, I'm pretty sure this is old tech. It's in all the cities. All the tracks were there. That we don't have much information on who was laying the tracks, who was building and designing the tracks, who was building and designing the trams, where all the power came from, and all this kind of stuff. It just, a lot of it just doesn't make sense. And as you can see, it looks like when, after the flood, when they were first uncovering these tracks and finding these trams, they were just hooking up horses to them and getting them drawn along. Don't know. Does that look like it's been made to be drawn by a horse? This hitch looks a bit strange. You know, that looks like it's sort of been added in as a retrofit. Not sure. You know, I don't know for sure, guys, obviously. But yeah, as you can see, this is what's going on. So we had all this free energy, we had free transport, nice and clean, everyone was looked after, and the people who wanted to rule the world, rule the earth, become the gods of earth and enslave everyone else, have taken it all, destroyed it, just like they do with the old buildings. Just like they do with everything, guys, pretty much. Look at the state of the ocean and the rivers and the forests, all this kind of stuff. Yeah, so that's pretty much what I wanted to say. Now I've got a bit of a video I want you guys to have a look at as well. So these trams were everywhere, and they were up to the 50s. There's a few cities have got them left, like Melbourne, Australia. San Francisco still has them, I'm sure. And there are other cities around, but most of them are gone. They've been ripped out because they were free, free energy, and basically, the people who are running the world didn't like things free. They want us to pay for everything. All right, so this is Perth. Again, look at all the architecture. This is 1901. Perth was founded, the Swan River Colony. In the 1840s, in 60 years, guys, this is, it's just unreal. Here's more trams. Look at all this, 1906, that's in England. Toronto, look how built up this is. Look at all the electricity, 1920. Washington, D.C. So these things were everywhere. All right, so guys, hang around, and I'm just gonna get into a video which will explain this a little bit more.
When asked how he could justify the treachery and deceit with which he had pursued the creation of the Standard Oil monopoly, John D. Rockefeller is reputed to have said, "Competition is a sin." Another existential threat to the vast fortunes of the early oligarchs was to require an even greater effort at social engineering: public transportation. By the end of World War I, private car ownership was still a relative rarity. Only 1 in 10 Americans owned a car. Rail was still the transportation of choice for the vast majority of the public, and city dwellers in most major cities relied on electric trolley networks to transport them around town. In 1936, General Motors formed a front company, National City Lines, along with Firestone Tire and Standard Oil of California, to implement a process of bustitution, scrapping streetcars and tearing up railways to replace them with GM's own buses running on Standard Oil supplied diesel. The plan was remarkably successful. As historian and researcher F. William Engdahl notes in Myths, Lies, and Oil Wars, by the end of the 1940s, GM had bought and scrapped over 100 municipal electric transit systems in 45 cities and put gas-burning GM buses on the streets in their place. By 1955, almost 90% of the electric streetcar lines in the United States had been ripped out or otherwise eliminated. The cartel had been careful to hide their involvement in National City Lines, but it was revealed to the public in 1946 by an enterprising retired naval lieutenant commander, Edwin J. Quimby. He wrote a manifesto exposing what he called a careful, deliberately planned campaign to swindle you out of your most important and valuable public utilities, your electric railway system. He uncovered the oligarch's stock ownership of National City Lines and its subsidiaries, and detailed how they had step by step bought up and destroyed the public transportation lines in Baltimore, Los Angeles, St. Louis, and other major urban centers. Quimby's warning caught the attention of federal prosecutors, and in 1947, National City Lines was indicted for conspiring to form a transportation monopoly and conspiring to monopolize sales of buses and supplies. In 1949, GM, Firestone, Standard Oil of California, and their officers and corporate associates were convicted on the second count of conspiracy. The punishment for buying up and dismantling America's public transportation infrastructure? A $5,000 fine. H.C. Grossman, who had been the director of Pacific City Lines when it oversaw the scrapping of Los Angeles's $100 million Pacific Electric system, was fined exactly $1.